I knew Sorkin was going to be a tough challenge. You know, he's a senior veteran and uses run and sink. And, you know, you put balls in play on him. We found some holes early and first run we scored. I don't even know if we hit a ball out of the infield. But we're going to have to learn to maximize, you know, offensively as we get a feel for – you see a lot of new names sprinkled in here, a lot of young guys. And I think Connor Porter gave us gave us an opportunity. We might have stayed with him a little bit long, but we'll learn some things as we go. But that, you know, they're a veteran club, Illinois State. They're a solid team, and I anticipate a good series.
Even though you only got the 2 runs on the 10 hits, you had to be happy with the 10 hits of this new lineup, seeing if they could do it, especially middle of the order. Tucker got himself a base hit. Beeler got a base hit. Drew Griffin got a base hit. You were able to get some production from the middle of the order.
Yeah, you know, and we we got to get a little better offensive night out of Ethan, and he's been very good in our preseason, and he'll get going. And, you know, we really don't have a true leadoff guy again. It's the second year in a row. We'll juggle some things and find the right combo. I thought Sorkin did a great job of denying our leadoff man on. I think we only got 2 leadoff men on the whole game, maybe. So we're playing with an out most innings that we started, and that's a veteran team.
Sam Malt didn't pitch bad 4 innings. He just got his pitch count up. Illinois State did what we did the last couple of years. Was able to kind of pitch count him a little bit tonight.
Yeah, their veteran hitters have pretty, you know, they have pretty good eyes. And Sam was up in the zone a little bit. And I thought his life was good. His stuff was good. He'll get better. I wish we could, you know, eliminate those 4 walks and the hit by pitch really built his pitch count. And that's what older hitters can have the ability to do. And our young guys will grow up. We're going to be okay.
Now you turn around quickly tomorrow, 2 o'clock, and it's going to be it was chilly tonight, and we expect it in February. They're saying there could be some snow tomorrow morning. I don't think it's going to affect the game at all, but you're looking at a game-time temperature maybe of 39, 40 degrees. It's going to be like those old Millington tournaments tomorrow. Eric's going to hit the rubber for you.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough challenge fighting that weather. You, when you're playing in it, it's okay. It's just when you're not moving around, it's a pretty tough day. But, you know, we got to rebound. We got to see how this bunch rebounds now. And they've put a lot into this. They've put a lot of effort into it, and we've stressed – taking things one day at a time, and our club will have a chance to do that tomorrow.
All right, we got 55 more to go. Long season, Coach.
Long season, and some guys got to grow fast.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. Final score, Illinois State wins it 5-2. 5 runs, 11 hits, 1 error, 12 left on. Memphis 2 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They leave a 9 on base. The winner is Sorkin 1-0. Mall takes a loss 0-1. Razzo gets the save, his first of the year. 3 hour and 4 minute game time, 5:76 in attendance. Our next broadcast of Tiger Baseball tomorrow. 2 o'clock first pitch in game 2 as the Tigers try to even it up. We'll be on the air at 1:45. For our producers in the studio, Chris Davis and Chris Freitas, the executive producer of the Memphis Tiger Network, if you're watching the stream, Wade Johnson, our head coach, Daron Shoenrock, and SID Mark Taylor, I'm Jeff Brightwell. Thanks for joining us, and good evening from FedEx Park.